Okay, good morning everybody. It's about 7:30 in the morning here on Sunday, whatever it is. I'm just going to start the Elk Mountain Trail, which starts at this Fielding Coal Creek Trail, and I'll be on this for around about a half an hour, a little bit more, until I get to the base of Elk Mountain and start on that trail. So here we go. Let's do this thing. Just about 8 minutes down the Fielding Trail here, and I think I can already see where I'm going to here. I think that's close to the peak of the Elk Mountain there, but because I have to go a little further south here, and I've just got started really, so but hey, it's going to be magnificent from up there from what I can see from here. This is a really beautiful trail here so far. I'm sure it gets even better. And wait till I get up on the mountain and get some panoramic scenic views there. Can't wait. So nice tall trees coming up here. It's a beautiful morning, perfect morning. Not a bit of a breeze, and so far not too hot. It's supposed to be about 24 degrees Celsius, so it'll be warm by the time I get done here. But this morning I have my jacket on a bit, and I was even wearing my gloves, so we had a bit of a shower last night, and it's a little chilly in the tent, but I was snug as a bug in a rug with my two sleeping bags there, so that's the main thing. I came out of there, which, you know, it's not marked very well to see when you're going to the mountain. But stop recording or what happened there, but anyway, I think it's just a little off to my left and continue on here from the tracks. Just announces that this is the Fielding Trail and how long it is from... not terribly encouraging, really, entering grizzly country. Make sure you got some bear spray. Guess I'll keep plugging along, and I have to go now till the Elk Mountain Trail starts at the base of the mountain up here. There's a patrol cabin or something up here, so I think it takes another 15 minutes here, maybe less here, to get along, so we'll see how we make out. Get a little more treed in here, but still very nice and well-pronounced trail to follow, so I don't think I'll have any problems. Okay, it's 24 minutes and 27 seconds into the hike here, and I'm just coming up to the cabin, I guess it is. So we'll see what that's in for. I'm gonna take my jacket off because it's just about 5 minutes to 8 here now. So I've been on the trail for 25 minutes, and it's getting a little warm in this jacket now. So I don't want to get overheated either. That wouldn't be good. I'm sure I got lots of time to get too hot later. And once I get coming up the mountain here and get into the sunlight more, then it'll definitely be more than I want. Oh yeah, this is the cabin for sure. Patrol or whatever it is. I don't know what they keep in there, but something they need to get once in a while maybe. Doesn't look like they got a lawnmower in there or anything, so they don't need to cut the grass. Okay, so, just a short distance up here, apparently there's a sign that says Elk Mountain Trail. So I'll just keep going up here. Oh, here's a sign coming up here. So it's not very far. Yeah, I figured there'd be something here soon, so. Good. Well, now I'll know where to come back to on the way back. And this, yep, sure enough, says Elk Mountain Trail. And 2.5 miles, 4 kilometers. Horse travel, not recommended. No, it's pretty steep, so I'm going to climb 3,400 feet in 2.5 miles. So if the horses can't do it, it's probably not going to be easy for me either. Anyway, I'm going to take my jacket off here and continue on this narrower trail, but still pretty pronounced, and I'm sure there's not any other ones around, so I shouldn't have any problem. Okay, so again, it's just 2 minutes to 8 here now, so I'm getting a good start. I can remember 8 o'clock I started up the trail, so we'll see how long it takes me. From about 24 minutes Elk Mountain Trail, getting a little windy here, and I finally come to a clearing. I'm still kind of south of, to the north and to the west here. And there's, I think you can see the Hamfest way down there. Yeah, from here. So that's maybe what it is, probably. So that's where I am so far. Okay, I'm at 6,238 feet.
Okay.
Got contact with some of them from the Hamfest, but some of them are pretty weak.
Yes, they're working.
This tree I'm just coming up to is kind of neat. It's the only one like it. It's just kind of dead with its branches all falling off to one side, so I don't know what the deal is with that, but this is fairly steep, so I'm just going slow. Well, this is about the pace I've been able to go at most of the way. It's fairly steep, but so keep your feet flat, take short steps, let your ankles do the work, not your legs so much. Just go, foot by foot, and eventually you get there. So, yeah, that's quite a workout, this trail. It's even more than I expected. I don't know exactly what I expected, but anyway, that tree I just mentioned earlier, I went by that, and shortly after that is where it started to turn up and come north here. So I'm finally where I was hoping. You can see down in the valley here below me, so, and the Hamfest is somewhere over there. At 6,496 feet, and it's 909. I wanted to take this picture just to show the grade more. This gives you a good idea about the elevation. It's around about this steep, maybe steeper in a few places, and it really hasn't been much less steep than this most of the way. So, you know, it's slow going. You really have to pace yourself the best you can do without playing yourself out, and take some breaks here and there. You can't go very fast, but this gives you an idea of what you're in for better, I think. Okay, I'm at 6,608 feet, and I just found some more scat here. Well, and it looks a little bit fresher. I think it's bear. So we better toot our horn. I'm not sure how fresh it is. Hello, bears. Hello, bears. Just me. Hello, bears. So, yeah, we'll just let him know I'm here and keep going. This is a pretty pronounced trail along here again yet, so I think as long as I keep talking and toot my horn, and that I'll hopefully be okay. I don't know how recent that is. A little bit nerving, but anyway, hopefully I'll get to a clearing here and take a break here for a bit. So, gain some more strength. This part's kind of steep here. It's 6,765 feet, and at this point on the trail, there's lots of these little whatever they are. But this is where I'm finally getting to see where I think I'm going up to from here. That's the summit of Elk Mountain. So now I can see at least what I'm in for. I think I still have to come up here. I'm kind of going up and to the north a bit still. So eventually I'm going to get to where I go more straight up here, I think, or something. Get along that ridge that I remember seeing about. So when I get to that, I think it'll just be a mount of more clearing and just going right to the summit and probably seeing it from where I am most of the time. But anyway, I think that's where I'm going up to. Yeah, I can see the ridge there. I'll go up along that way somehow there. I don't know. Halfway point, I'm at 69.25. Windy up here. A little bit cool. I put my jacket on, but the wind isn't so bad. I'll manage the wind. So I'm going to call in shortly and check in, see how everyone's doing on the radio. Should be okay. So I'm making good progress. And I think I'm at that ridge or close to it now. So hopefully I'll be able to have a clear shot of the summit here shortly. Now, 7,097 feet. There's the half-fest site down there. And I'm just sitting on the rock here relaxing, taking in some water. And my legs are starting to cramp up a bit now, so maybe I've been going a little too much, too fast, I don't know. But I'm not in as good a shape as I hoped I was. But it's pretty cool. From this point, I'm going along this ridge, and I can see all the way to where I'm going. Let me just stand up and show you here. Nice. Once you get to the ridge line, you can follow your way all the way, and you can pretty much see right to the top here. You know, the wind isn't so bad. It keeps you cool. Probably better than a hot, calm day. I don't know. But anyway, I think I'm doing okay here now. Legs feel better. Got to keep hydrated and take some breaks along the way if you need to. Don't go too fast. Take short steps. Another break here. My legs are cramping up pretty good. 1,835 feet is the summit. There's the entrance right down there. Magnificent view. South and down the valley, looking west. There's the south again. Just a great looking view. 7,835 feet. And I'm at 7,166 feet at this point. So I just got a break here and take a little bit of water on and relax and try to keep my legs from cramping up here. So hopefully I can make it up to the top from here. There it is. I hope we can see that. So not too much further. I'd like to try to make it. Let's just take another little break here. I got about 600 feet to go to the summit, which doesn't seem very far, but my legs are cramping up pretty good along the way, so I'm just taking a break, and this is a good shot of the ridge line I've been following for a bit from this point, and there's the Hamfest down there. Really good view from here down to there. So I'm going to start up again here. I don't know how I'll make out, but the problem's the leg. I think this waist pack, I'm trying to hold it up with my arm or my hand and keep it right off the front of my legs. It's the front muscles of my legs that are cramping up. The rest is fine. So I think the trick is to not have too much weight on your waist like I have, and I would have probably been okay, but we'll see how we can do here. I still got to go 600 feet, so I guess we'll see how I make out now. So, it's just 2 minutes to 10 o'clock, so I've been going at it for about 2 hours. 600 feet. I think I'll probably make it if I can make it with my legs in a reasonable break. Legs are holding out, not too bad. But I want to take one more break. There's a Hamfest site down there. Just amazing. Amazing view. Really windy up here today. It's a good thing I got my buff on. Keeps the wind out of my ears and it's not going to blow off my head. It's amazing. Tell you not. Here's my first look around Nicholas, St. Nicholas. From here. That's at 7,000. Maybe it's not quite that. Maybe it's more. I forgot now, but I'm not far anyway. So I'm holding out. Shouldn't be too much further. Yeah, this is quite a workout. It's 8:22. 8:22. I'm at 7,790 feet. The summit. I made it. Holy cow. Magnificent. There there's Mount St. Nicholas, looking down the valley. We can see the anchors for what used to be a lookout here, fire lookout apparently. Looking east at some of the other peaks here along the ridge, and someone's made some inukshuks, what do you call them, here. Okay, they're 7,798 feet. I think that's pretty close to where I'm supposed to be. Amazing view. Amazing view. This is looking east. I'll come down here to the valley here. Mountains along the way here. It's always easy to remember, it's only sharp peaked one. And turning towards west here. Looking south here, just magnificent view. All the mountains here, lots of snow on some of them, none up here. I thought there was some snow along the way, but it's just white rock here, I guess, so. Magnificent. And there's the number two highway down there, and there's the railroad tracks going back on your way to East Glacier, where I came from. So there you go. That's magnificent from the summit. Been quite a hike here, but I made it. My legs are cramping up quite a bit the last 600 or 800 feet when I got on the ridge line, but I took a few breaks and managed to make it. That's the main thing, and I'm sure going down will be easier, or at least I sure hope so. wonderful view here. 7,835 feet is the 835 feet, so there must be a higher point around here. 7,835 feet. Let's see if I can find that. 7,835 feet. I'm 30 feet away, guys I can call on the ham radio here, see if they're around for me. Kilo Lima 7, Hotel Mike, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, Smoke Whiskey 7 from the summit, over.
Roger, Brass, Kilo 7, Hotel Mike, you read your log. Roger, Roger, Hugh. Thanks for being there. Glad I finally made it. I had to go in the last 600 to 800 feet. My legs were cramping up pretty good, so I had to go slow and take lots of breaks and drink lots of water, but I made it. I'm sure it'll be a lot easier going down, over. Famous, by the way. I'm sitting here at 7,797.98 feet, and I was at 7,803 feet, I think, at my highest. I couldn't find the 35-foot point, but that's close enough, I think. So I guess I'll call it a summit, over. Oh, very good. Well, I'm glad to be sure. I'm very glad I could make contact with you, and I really appreciate you being here. I'll call you again when I get further down and along the way here. So far, it's been pretty good. I only found one bear scat that was fairly fresh around the halfway point, maybe, but I was okay, Rob, go ahead. Yes, Roger, right on the summit. Just having a break here, taking some video for YouTube, and a little break. Well deserved, I might add. So glad to make your contact from up here, too. Alpha 7, Alpha Mike. Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, Stroke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit, over.
I know it's Alpha Echo 7, Alpha Echo 7, Alpha Papa, and I have you in the log at
34. Okay, Alpha Echo 7, Alpha Papa, got it, very good. Yeah, thanks for putting me in the log there. I've been here for maybe about 10 minutes now. I had to make some camera just blew over. It's really windy up here. Really windy up here. But it was a good hike anyway, and I didn't get too hot, so. But I'll spend a few more minutes up here and make my way back down. So, anyone else to make a contact from the summit here? This is Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, Smoke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit, over. Alpha Echo 7, Alpha Quebec, loud and clear from the summit, over.
Congratulations on making it to the top. How are the views up there, right?
Oh, really amazing, really amazing. Yeah, I never did anything quite like this before, so it's been a great experience and a great reward at the end, over.
Awesome job, and you had a terrific time. Wow, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, this is AE7AQ. Congratulations.
Great, thank you very much. Anybody else? CQ from the Elk Mountain Summit. Summit, Victor Echo 5, Charlie Stroke Whiskey 7. CQ, CQ, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie Stroke Whiskey 7. I guess that's all for now. So thanks everyone for being there. I'll make my way down pretty soon. I'll announce when I'm on my descent. 73 for now.
B5MC.
Now, can I get that phonetically, please? November 7, Mike Alpha Bravo. You're loud and clear. Fox, Kilo Fox, loud and clear from the Elk Mountain Summit, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, Smoke Whiskey 7, over.
Victor Echo 7, Mike Charlie, Smoke Whiskey 7, NHFK.
Okay, great. It's Victor Echo 5. 3345. Okay, very good. Anybody else from the Elk Mountain Summit? Thank you. From Victor Echo 5, Charlie, book Whiskey 7. Over. November 7, Mike. Loud and clear from the Elk Mountain Summit. Yeah, that's correct. Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7, over.
Okay, we got you in the log, and we'll continue.
Great, thanks very much. CQ, CQ from the Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit, over.
Okay, I'm going to call CQ. Apparently there was some people busy earlier for the Hamfest site. Maybe I'll get a few more people before I leave here. It's just 10:51, and I'll probably leave here soon. We'll see who I get. CQ, CQ, anybody for a contact from the Elk Mountain Summit? This is Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, Beautiful Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit. Calling CQ, CQ, over.
Kilo Delta 7,
Delta Juliet Zulu, was it? This is Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7, loud and clear from the summit, over.
Good deal, Mike Charlie. The call sign is Kilo Delta 7, Juliet Zulu. Kilo Delta 7, Juliet Zulu. Q5, good luck.
Kilo Delta 7, Juliet Zulu. Thank you very much. Anybody else from the summit of Elk Mountain? Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7, over.
Victor
Echo 6, Quebec Bravo Delta, loud and clear from the Elk Mountain Summit, over. I can copy that. There's too much wind noise in your mic. Site of the Hamfest from here. Very good, thank you. CQ, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit. Anybody for contact, over? Okay, too much wind noise in the mic that time again. Whiskey Alpha Niner, Yankee Foxtrot, is it? Okay, Yankee Foxtrot, Foxtrot. I think I got that now. Lots of wind noise in your mic, but you're also good signal otherwise. Thanks for the contact, over. Did I get that call right? Yankee Foxtrot, Foxtrot, over. Okay, very good. CQ, CQ, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit, over. CQ, CQ, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit. Anyone for a contact, over? Okay, it's 6 minutes to 11. I think I'm 6 minutes to 11. It'll make it easy to remember when I left. So I'll start my descent in another 6 minutes or so. This is Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7.
K7IUI,
you're loud and clear on the Elk Mountain Summit, over.
Yeah, I'm down here at the to make your contact. Home QTH is Helena, and so hope you have a safe.
very much for the call. Yeah, very good. Yeah, I'm from Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan, so, and this is my first time over here, so it's been a great adventure coming up this mountain, so first time for me. So, thanks for the call. Anyone else? CQ, CQ, Victor 25, Mike Charlie, Silk Whiskey 7 from the Elk Mountain Summit. Over. Stoke Whiskey 7, Elk Mountain Summit, over.
Okay, that appears to be it for the moment. Made a lot of contacts, I'm surprised. Probably most of them from the Handfest site, but nevertheless, I'm surprised. A lot of people still around this morning. So it's 4 to 11, so I'm going to wait another 4 minutes, and then I'll start my descent at 11 o'clock. So. We made it to the top. I'm sure we'll make it back down just fine. 73 for now. I just passed this little gorge, you know, that there's no water at the moment. It might be at some times, but this is a little gorge that I went up where I kind of changed direction on the way up. I left at 11 o'clock. From the summit to come back down, and it's just 5 minutes to noon right now, so it's taken me 55 minutes to get down to this point. So just for reference, it's good to know. So we're making our way back down, and a little bit of a sore toe because it's a little hard to come down here. It's not near as hard on the legs, but it's harder than you think it is on the legs. But anyway, making good progress, and I'm at 6,100 feet now. 6,100 feet, so. I'm always ahead of myself thinking I'm getting there, but finally I'm at the end of the Elk Mountain Trail. Come back down, and finally I'm here. My God, it's been a long haul. It's 12:38. And there's the Elk Mountain Trail sign again. So I made it up and I made it down. Now I'm going back on the Fielding House Trail. There's the cabin that I passed earlier. So I'm going to announce myself here. Hello, bears! Hello, bears! Just me coming back down. So get out of the way. I'll just be a few minutes. Hello, bears! Okay. And now I'm going to make a radio call here and let them know where I am too, when I get to the cabin here. So, let's see, my contact is Kilo Lima 7 Hotel Mike, so we'll see if we can find him here. Kilo Lima 7 Hotel Mike, I'm monitoring you. This is Victor Echo 5 Mike Charlie, Stoke Whiskey 7 at the patrol cabin, the end of the Elk Mountain Trail, over. Yeah, roger, roger. You're breaking up a little bit for me, but I copied that okay. And yeah, the ranger cabin. So I've made it up and I've made it down. I'm just on the Fielding House Trail now, so probably be back at my car in about a half an hour or so. So thanks again for monitoring. Over.
Roger. No problem. We enjoyed it. Let us know when you get back to your car, would you please?
Yeah, I sure will. I will. Not quite out of the woods yet, as they say. But great experience, so I'll call you back in probably around a half an hour, maybe a little less. 73 for now.
73,
okay, so I'm at 4,822 feet, and it's 1240 now, so that's been it's been pretty good. Quite an experience, for sure. So let's see. Yeah, there we are, back at the cabin. And this here is the Fielding House Trail again. So now they know where I am, and it's been good to be able to keep in contact most of the way. And now I've got, like I say, half an hour, maybe a little less, on a much easier trail to make it back to the car. And I'm feeling okay. I don't think I'll have much of a break. I might stop along the way here and have a drink or two and just relax for a little bit, but at this point I think I'm okay to just keep going and get it over with. This is Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7. Okay, everybody, it's 1:05, and I'm at 4,530 feet, and I'm back where I started, at the beginning of the Fielding Coal Creek Trail. And here's my car. Nobody stole it. That's good. So I'm just going to call in here and let them know that I'm okay. Kilo Lima 7, Hotel Mike, Victor Echo 5, Mike Charlie, stroke Whiskey 7.
Hey, Willie, this is you, Hotel 78 Jim. I hear you loud and clear here. Are you at your car?
Yeah, that's Roger here. I'm here. I haven't got in it yet, but I'm all done, and I should be back at the Hamfest sites shortly, so it'll be good to relax for a bit. I'm spent. Go ahead.
Roger, we'll see you when you get back here. Drive carefully.
Roger, thanks, you. 7-3.